BCTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.
Good evening and welcome to Poets Pause. My name is Marilyn Klimcho, and this evening I have the great pleasure of introducing a poet that most of you haven't heard before. But before I get into that, let me remind you that Berks Bards has First Thursday every month in the Goggle Works on the first Thursday of the month at 6 p.m. And we usually have a featured reader. We also have an open mic, so you should try to bring your poems, bring your friends, and bring your friends' poems and share them. So my guest this evening loves Robert Frost and E.E. Cummings. And since those are both very popular poets and you're all familiar with them, I won't try to read a few lines of their poetry. What I want to do is get to introducing you to Maggie Kruezberger. She's a friend of mine that I met at the writers group that meets every Saturday in the Goggle Works in room 413, which if you are looking for a critique group, that's a wonderful place to get your material heard and to get feedback from other writers. We meet at 10 o'clock in the morning and go till about noon. And Maggie is a steadfast member of that group since she moved back to Reading in 2017. So Maggie grew up in Reading.
Yep.
And at 17, she went into the convent and was there for about 9 years, where she wrote some of her poetry. After that 9-year stint, she went to the University of Nebraska in Lincoln and spent 4 years there studying. And while she was there, she had serious back surgery from which her back has never really returned to the upright posture we would hope for. She spent 17 years in North Platte, Nebraska, teaching, and she says that was the best period of her life. Then she had a health crisis and moved to Miami for 30 years, where she taught at the University of Miami as Associate Director of the Writing Center and had herself published in University of Miami magazines and several other publications. She spent time at the school in St. Thomas School of Law and at Barry University teaching there as well. So she moved back in 2017, and we are so glad to have you. Welcome to the program, Maggie.
Thank you.
We're going to do something unusual this year with this program because Maggie has a great deal of difficulty with speaking for any length of time. She and I have agreed that I will do the reading of some of her poems and she'll do the reading of a few of them. So while you're still feeling strong, Maggie, do you want to start off with reading a poem or two, or should I lead off? And what would you like to start with?
I can start with Edge of a One. About my high school days, I made a naive narrator as the speaker of a poem, and it was about my Algebra 1 teacher, who I did not like at all.
I love this poem. Go ahead.
Algebra 1. A native almost straight from Poland. She stands before us, wagging her tongue in disjointed graphs of sound. Excite, 1, 2, 3. Times trial to the ends. Her voice grinds up time into cubes of sweat, and she knows it. She intercepts my vector gaze. Shoot her to look at the clock, Kruezberger. I will tell you when it is time to go, Kruezberger. Her face is red with rage, as if I drenched her with my sweat, and she has mispronounced my name again. The war is all, and Warsaw now lays daily siege on Berlin. Her black eyes hooked on her bird-like nose glitter with equations. I couldn't care less, lady. We move in different quadrants. Our points do not touch and never will.
I have to confess that my experience in algebra was that at the end, I wanted to raise my hand and ask the teacher why we were doing this. I did not understand it. And in that same vein, you have a poem to A Leaden Sky, which was written to a member of the convent who had a very, very angry, ugly personality.
She was in the group behind mine. And yeah. She looks very set jaw all the time, a look angry face. And I think, like, what's wrong with you? What's going on in your mind? Then I thought sometimes you have to smile. But so I wrote a poem, and I used nature to describe what she was like. It's to a leaden sky. Listen, clouds, who are you trying to fool? You only try to hide what you cannot rise above. Dark, brooding face. Don't you think I know the sun you mask will melt you to tears, and you are bound to break into yawning reaches of blue?
This poem is just so wonderful because you can take all of that animus that you're feeling of frustration and with another individual that you can't actually fight with. And you can get that out and know that you've got something that will allow you to deal with their personality. The other things I love about your work, and these are the love poems and the love poems to the Great Plains. And I don't know which one you want to go into next. And you let me know when you want me to do the reading.
You can do the reading of the love poems to the person that I love.
And okay.
I will do the Great Pains one.
Okay. All right. Should I do to Dad?
What?
Will I do the one to Dad?
No, that's not one. That's do the naturalization.
Okay.
Poem, and the Pa gets hit by a northeaster.
Okay, all right, I will do that. So naturalization, and this is a beautifully short and wonderful poem. In an unfamiliar land, foreign eyes found mine and turned me into a native. That is gorgeous. And you want Pa gets hit by a nor'easter, Ma decides to go shuck clams next?
Yeah, no poem. They put the sonnet. The very blessed time I see you, baby. You have that one?
Every time I see you, baby, hang on a minute. Ah, yeah, this one's titled Poem.
Yeah.
Every blessed time I see you, baby, riot and chaos and all the furies wreak havoc in me. Thought sonnets barrage me. Those sonnets barrage me. My feet stumble. My meter runs amok. Reasoned verse, roses are red, violets are blue, deserts me. Spontaneous rhymes moves me. Spontaneous rhythm moves me. You make me forget internal divisions, schemes, all extraneous things to the real poem. Decadent lines pepper out in choppy breath lengths. My iams and trochees laugh and cry at the same time. My lines are too feminine to scan. What's wrong with my sonnets is you, baby. You defy them all with poetry. I would love to know who that was written to. I would love to know.
He was a great guy.
I would love to know all the people that you reacted to. There's love letter too. Do you want me to read that one?
Yeah.
Letter love.
Yes, you can do that.
Okay, this one's called letter love. Tell me you are gentle when you touch me. Tell me you are tender when you taste me. Tell me you are taken when you take me. Tell me when you cannot touch me. Tell me when you can not taste me. Tell me when you can not take me. Take me with your words. A lot of these too are really, really best seen on the page.
Yes.
Because you play with the structure of the verse. And in this letter love, tell me is its own line on every stanza. Or on every line. Okay, what would you like to read next?
August had hit by a northeaster.
Okay, do you want to read this one?
That was a northeaster. Hey, we called each other Pa and Ma, even though we were not yet married. But so it's called Pockets Hit by a Northeaster. Ma decides to go shuck clams. No vacations, Ma. Farmer's got a full farm full time come April, he says to me. He says, no running off to the main coast, much as I'd like to, he says to me. He says, too much to center. Weed waves, leafy garden tops, grasshoppers. Grasshoppers defoliating gardens, decimating ranks of wheat. Grasshoppers buzzing the denims. No chemicals. Beef, bread, broccoli. Rhubarb, radishes, rutabaga, roosters, organically fed. Grasshoppers are organically increasing, multiplying, subduing the earth. Roosters by hundreds pecking lawns, gardens, fields, pastures. Organically packing away speared, hopping high protein flesh, filling out the feathers. Reckless Springer Spaniel, six flanked by tigers and calicos stalking Rhode Island reds. Roosters wheeling, lengthening, charging. Retreat, no bugles. Big Alice, charmer that she is, revving too high, paw on top, plowing the fertile plain, bouncing placidly, loudly snapping his double mint on the undulations, ears purring to the piston strokings of the engine. Equipment breaking down, driving the pickup to town for parts. Paul snuffling, bellowing, pawing. Evers watching, chasing the mares, enticing with apples, riding into glory. Windmills pumping, shooting the breeze in spirals. Watching swirls of clouds, funnels forming, electric light. Hiking canyons, jogging hills on slow days. Eating fresh melons, spitting out the seeds. Peeling carrots, coring apples, shelling nuts. Kenning orgasmics. Cool air breathing, curtains brushing across the body at night. Skin alive, coyote curdles, waiting for morning. "Hell, Pa," I says to him, I says, "summer ain't no time to get laid up on the land."
I guess I love this so much because I came from a country setting myself, and I know what you're talking about. And your love for this land, especially like the Great Plains, it's just amazing. And Laramie Peak, I don't know which one of those you want to do next. Do you want to read them or should I? I'm not terribly good at it, but.
I will try one more, but I think I'm running out of steam.
Okay.
There's Laramie Peak, the last 50 feet. My heart tells me I must stop again for a minute until it stops pounding me alive, beating me to death. Beating the odds, I've climbed this far. Fake book I will finish. Far below, a fire spreads. Not far above, the ranger watches. He breathes this rare air, I guess, bat. He breathes it always, deep and slow. Must keep my head. Just slow. Small steps, slow, deep breaths. Can't miss the top. Can't miss that view. Can't miss.
Okay, and can I follow that by reading Plain Song?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So this is called Plain Song. I do not belong in this place. My muse does not live here. She sings the song of the plains and will not move to Miami. I beg her, listen to the salsa. Surrender to the reggae. Dance to the voice of the Caribbean night. Let us all hang out in the colors of wild parrots, the easy sway of palms, the jingle of pendulous jewelry, the glitz of jaguars tamed by Rolexed wrists, Gucci'd feet. She responds, the silence of Nebraska night, punctuated with crickets and an occasional coyote. She answers endless blendings of muted browns and greens, gold splashed with meadowlarks profiled on fence posts, thrilling the air with notes electric. She hums to the drone of tractors, driven by Timex wrists, acmeed feet. Her motif, this earth once sea, this undulating tall grass prairie, defines in waves her breath celestial. Her aspirations cold and dry as winter, desiccating hot as summer. Move this sea of grass within me, an ocean calls me come. And leaves me here a sea. It must have been very, very hard for you to leave the Great Plains.
Yes, my heart is still there.
You know, I've listened to your poetry and I haven't heard a one about enjoying Miami. And yet you spent, what, 30 years there?
Yeah, I spent 30 years there.
Yeah.
I had very good friends there. But that was the extent of it. I don't like big cities. I don't like them. And Miami's, it has all the glitz and Miami Vice was really very accurate about Miami. It's a mean city, a very mean city. And the only thing good about it is the weather and some of the friends that I found there. And my church. But that was it. I did not like it.
Yeah. Yeah. I've only been in Florida once. And what I loved there were the lizards on the sidewalk.
Oh, yes. They are neat.
They are wonderful.
Little geckos.
Yeah, I loved them. It was so different to see them on the sidewalk ahead of you, and then they would dart under.
Yes,
the nearby.
They are cute. I love the lizards.
Yeah, they were my favorite.
Yeah. So.
So we have. Let's see. Let me see what we were talking about.
You can all read yolk. Yolk.
Yolk? I don't think I have yolk.
I submitted it to you last night.
I didn't. Did I get?
Okay, well.
Let me look.
I have it, but I cannot read it just right now.
Yeah, that's fine. You rest. I don't see yolk. I know I put them all in here.
Do you have energy efficient?
Say that again.
Energy efficient.
No, I don't have that. Those are the ones I didn't have.
Okay, We could go to the back surgery ones.
Okay. All right. And I apologize. I didn't get those. So let me do the back surgery ones.
We have 5 minutes left.
Oh, okay. All right. Well then, do you want out of the cradle?
Yeah, that's good.
Okay. So out of the cradle, and these come from your experience after back surgery, which was not terribly successful. Out of the cradle. Out of the cradle, endlessly rocking, so rough I sweat cold and chatter. The things coming apart, the center cannot hold on big baby. Oh, scream, fright mute, for help to endless silence rocking the cradle with furious rhythmic beat. And what exactly was this cradle? This was some kind of construction that they put you in?
No. This is an allusion to Walt Whitman's poem, Out of the Cradle Endlessly Rocking.
Okay.
And I moved it to the, it's about this, it's the stuff that you cannot escape, and it's the things happening to you that are rocking you like a cradle. You can't get out, that was the pain.
That's endless frustration. And I see we're coming down on time. Is there one? How about backs the stooped? Did you want to read, have that one on, or Odyssey?
I don't have that with me, but you have it, so you can read it too.
Okay, stooped. Lord, I am not humbled, I am stooped. This hump on my back reminds me I am stooped. I am what I am. Help me be what I am. Enter this domed temple. Make me a dome of the rock of ages, the life of this temple humbled by your presence within.
Thank you.
That's yeah. And I could do Odyssey of Pain also. That's Isaiah 50.
Yeah, you can do that one if you have time.
I think we do. My face is set as most hard rock. This summit vantage points my way. A caterpillar train of mountains purples out, devoid of plain. Vision blurs, horizon humps, bridging hump to hump beyond. And God, the ragged world is round. The highest crest, each mount I climb, but left behind is lost to view. My face is set as most hard rock. To scale and cry, to scale and cry. I grasp my granite from a star that dies to dawn and dies to die in stubborn hope of utter day.
Yes.
Yeah, I am so glad you were able to join me on this. And it looks like we've got 1 minute left. So let me remind my viewers that I've had Maggie Kruezberger on the show today, leading off January, the new year, and remind you that Burke's Bards offers first Thursday on the first Thursday of every month at 6 p.m. in the Goggle Works. And I think possibly in February, we're doing a Zoom session, but stay tuned. You'll see the emails come out about that. Maggie, it's been a real pleasure to have you on. Thank you so much for being my guest.
Thank you for inviting me. I'm glad I came.
Thank you.
BCTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.